Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa, and today I'm making no-bake, gluten-free cappuccino tiramisu cake. Tiramisu is a layered dessert, often considered a cake, that is primarily flavored with coffee. It is typically made by soaking finger biscuits in coffee that may be mixed with a liqueur. Lady fingers are then arranged in a dish so that mascarpone mixture can be layered on top. Word tiramisu, derived from the Venetian dialect tiramisu, which means pick me up, often thought to be referring to the energy-boosting caffeine and sugar content. There are several legends about the birth of the tiramisu. Some say that it was conceived in Piemont by Turinese chef to support Camillo Benso, Count of Cavour, while performing his work of Italy's reunification. Even further back in time, it is said that tiramisu was created in Tuscany around 1600 during the visit of Cosimo III de' Medici in Siena. However, the two most commonly recognized regions of origin are Friuli Venezia Giulia and Veneto. Most of the theses attribute, in fact, the paternity of the tiramisu to the city of Treviso, where sometime in the 1960s, at the restaurant Alle Beccherie, the pastry maker Roberto Linguanotto made it for the first time. However, many disagree, like the towns of Tolmezzo and Pieris of San Canzian di Zonzo, claiming the origin of this dessert. And again, as it is usual in the world of sweetness, nobody knows for sure where, when, how, and by whom a certain dessert was invented. So we can only wonder and enjoy. Now, today I'm making a bit different tiramisu. Instead of lady fingers, I'll make a chocolate cookie crust, and no, I will not soak it with coffee. Nope, I'll do better and make an additional layer of pure sweetness, cappuccino mousse. Yummy! So let's get to work and make one hell of a pick-me-up. My lovely, no-bake, gluten-free cappuccino tiramisu cake. As usual, the recipe is on my site and the link is in the description below. To make the chocolate crust, I've put ground gluten-free chocolate cookies into a bowl. I will add melted butter and stir with a silicone spatula. I'll transfer the mixture into a 16 cm, which is 6.3 inches in diameter, and 6 cm, which is 2.3 inches high cake ring that I've previously lined with acetate strip. I will even out the mixture using the bottom of a glass. Then I'll smooth the edges with my small spatula. I will put everything in the fridge to set. To make cappuccino mousse, I'll soak gelatin in cold water. As soon as my gelatin softens, I'll take it out and squeeze to get rid of the excess water. I've put milk into a bowl. I'll add sugar and stir with a whisk. I will heat up this mixture in the microwave. My milk is hot. I'll add instant coffee and soaked gelatin and stir with the whisk until everything melts. I've melted my white chocolate in the microwave on low heat, and now I'll add milk and coffee mixture. I'll stir with whisk until uniform. I've put cream into a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with whisk attachment, and I'll mix on medium speed until soft peaks form. I'll add white chocolate and coffee mixture into the whipped cream and stir until uniform. I will pour the cappuccino mousse into the cake ring. Then I'll put everything in the freezer until it sets. To make mascarpone mousse, I'll put gelatin in cold water. As soon as my gelatin softens, I'll take it out and squeeze to get rid of the excess water. I've put milk into a bowl. I'll add sugar and stir with a whisk. I will heat up this mixture in the microwave. My milk is hot, I'll add soaked gelatin and stir until it melts. I've put mascarpone cream cheese into a bowl, and now I'll add milk and gelatin mixture, amaretto liqueur, and stir well with a whisk. I've put cream into a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with whisk attachment, and I'll mix on medium speed until soft peaks form. I'll add mascarpone mixture into the whipped cream and stir until uniform. I'll pour the mixture onto frozen cappuccino mousse until I fill the mold to the top. Then I'll shake the mold to distribute it evenly and put everything in the freezer until it sets. My tiramisu cake is set. I will place a stencil onto the cake and dust it generously with cocoa powder. Then I will carefully remove the stencil. Now I'll decorate my cake with some red currants. There, my delicious, no-bake, gluten-free cappuccino tiramisu cake is done. Enjoy!
Oh, baby, you are so sweet. So delicious and yummy. So good to eat. I wanna lick you. Feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you want to stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And of course, visit my site, where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site, you can download my free 365 pages ebook, The Pastry Chef, and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!